So The Flying Sailor, this is an animated short. I found this on the list of Annie nominations, and it is by directors, about two female directors, by Amanda Forbes, I guess, and Wendy Tilby. They have worked together on a bunch of different animated films, including things like Wildlife, for example, Wildlife, When the Day Breaks, things like that. I don't really know them before this. I just checked this out because I thought it was cool, and it is. It's sort of a mix of different animation styles. You have 2D, you have kind of a more of a sketchy style, you have live action footage. It's a mishmash of various things, but it is about a real life kind of catastrophe, the Halifax explosion of 1917, in which two ships, one carrying a ton of TNT, crashed into each other and caused one of what is considered at the time the largest explosion known to man, and destroyed like blocks and blocks of Halifax. And this is based on the story of one, I think it's a fireman, but I kept seeing it places different people. I know there was a fireman who saw that there was a fire on these ships, was sort of like, was at the docks. There was an explosion happened. He was thrown. All of his clothes were basically burned or thrown off. He wound up 2 kilometers naked away from the explosion and survived without a scratch on him, other than just being naked, I guess. That'd be embarrassing. But basically what this short is about, The Flying Sailor, is what was that experience like being thrown from the explosion to the point where you woke up and you're naked. And it's kind of actually really fascinating and beautiful. You see him, the moment of the explosion, with all this kind of surreal experimental more animation. And you see him have flashbacks to his childhood and his life and becoming a sailor and things like that. And while he's like flying through the air, and you have him sort of have near-death experiences, it gets abstract again. It plays around with things. And the two directors, when I saw them talk about it, they talked about it, how it was, how important kind of these little moments are to your life, but how like inconsequential you are sort of to the universe at the same time, while also how glorious and beautiful it probably is to, as catastrophic and horrible it is, how instantly kind of captivating and beautiful that experience is in general. It's really kind of a really fascinating, amazing short, and I was really taken aback by it because I like kind of showing like various moments of your life, and so I make those month videos, and I think showing that through the Halifax explosion of 1917, particularly like an incident that I think works perfect for a short film, is just like, can you imagine like being in one part of Halifax and you see, you know, a thriving city, and then explosion happens, you're thrown. Like, I'm assuming that 2 kilometers, I don't know what the kilometer mile ratio actually is, but like being thrown and then waking up naked and kind of like seeing this whole city transform underneath you is just, I don't know. It's a very, I guess they call it an unexpected existential journey, as the Wikipedia calls it. But it is, I think, almost like kind of reminds you of when you're in those instant moments of peril. When you're in those moments of peril, everything that's going through your mind, everything that you've been through, everything, you know, having life flash by your eyes and like what that is like and things. It's surreal, it's weird, but it has this like instant kinetic moment to it. You kind of forget he's flying in the air at a certain moment. You just think like, maybe this is just like what life is. Maybe this is the end of life, everything like that. Apparently like the actual incident, from what I've read, sounds far more horrible and chaotic and things like that. But this is a really wonderful animated short. One thing I really like about this is it understands like what a short really is. It's just like a quick little moment, but it's a very memorable moment. I was really taken aback by this. I didn't know about the Halifax explosion in 1917, but it made me think about like what would that be like? Like you live through this huge explosion and you wake up and you're just naked. And like, what was that journey like? And they did change from what the directors admitted, actually, they changed the real life person to more of the person they wanted in this, and they did try to make it as accurate as they could as well. But I think most of it is in capturing kind of like this extreme moment of peril and what is going through someone's mind. And maybe it's like, you know, imagine, because I don't think they interviewed this guy, like just seeing that like brought to the big screen kind of brings into memory how important memory is, how, you know, maybe none of it matters or something, but maybe that experience, like being brought into it and stuck into it and brought into this flying sailor's mind and what that all represents to both him and the experience of the whole thing. And just like, almost like what it would be like to live through a chaotic kind of action sequence of real life horror and what's going through your brain. It's almost more internal, while the experience, I guess, more is thought of as external, but they bring it in. It feels so personal. You're just kind of stuck in this perspective that's swirling around in its own brain. It is a really wonderful short. I highly recommend it. It is on YouTube right now. At the time I'm reviewing this, I don't know if this is going to be nominated for an Oscar or not, but that shouldn't matter to you. You should still absolutely see this. It's definitely a really memorable, wonderful short, and they did an amazing job, not just bringing you into history, but bringing you into the psyche of what it'd be like to be stuck in that history and kind of spit out the other side of it.